Imagine you're asked to machine a one-of-a-kind object to solve a unique problem. And then imagine that that problem is part of a wider project to keep our nation safe. And then imagine that you have all of the tools and all of the leadership and a diverse and collaborative team to make that project a reality. Can you imagine what you could do? Welcome to Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory's manufacturing facility.
The lab has an ecosystem. That ecosystem is made up of supercomputers that we have down the road, design, test, facilities like the National Ignition Facility, big experimental facilities out at Site 300 where we do stockpile testing, and manufacturing is a key part of it. We have a combination of old school, traditional manufacturing techniques, very manual, all the way up to hybrid, additive manufacturing, next generation manufacturing, smart manufacturing, things that we talk about, machine learning and things of that nature, where we're actually going beyond what's capable on the outside and using it, again, primarily to meet the stockpile mission.
Stockpile stewardship is the laboratory's core mission, and the manufacturing facility is key to that mission's success. When the inevitable unique challenge comes their way, this team knows they have everything they need to succeed.
It never surprises me when they come back and say, Blanca, we couldn't do it on the outside. We have to use manufacturing here on site. Can our people do it here? And sometimes we're able to and sometimes we can't. But the best thing is when we can't, then they'll come back and say, hey, how about we try it this way? What, can we change this? Can we do this? And then we really work with the customer to try to, and the customers are great. They're like, perfect, I didn't even think about that, or I didn't know we could do that. And so the communication between the customer and manufacturing is key.
So we definitely work with our counterparts in different shops if they need our assistance to the end product about timeline delivery. We could also do a pre-inspection on the parts being made on the floor. It's all because we don't have to wait for the finished part. We can inspect as it's being made to let them know where they're at with their fixturing design or tooling or how close the tolerances are coming in to spec from how they're working on it in real time.
Having all of these tools and this body of knowledge at your disposal is great, but you don't just walk in here and know what to do. So you need this strong culture of mentorship and guidance and the well-established apprenticeship program to build on this foundation that is now 50 years strong.
Learned a lot of different things, worked on a lot of different machines, new tools, new setups, basic parts, complex parts. I'll get started on that on the computer, bring up the 3D model, and start planning it from there. If I have any problems, I can go ask any of the guys around here who have years of experience, and they can guide me through that process.
Opportunities like the apprenticeship program form great teams, and then those teams can collaborate to solve some of the biggest and most unique challenges the laboratory faces every day.
It's great to think that they can come up with these great ideas. They have it in their head, they put it in the computer, and we could do this, but actually to make it is a whole different animal, right? So trying to come up with how we're going to do this, how we're going to make that a reality, and how we're actually going to configure, whether it's holding tight tolerances or whether it's using different types of materials, experimenting with different types of materials. We have those capabilities here.
Day to day is all completely different. Depends on what our customer needs are, from what NIF needs us to do to help calibrate their diagnostics that are going to be used on a shot, to Heath needing us to characterize parts that are being made just to make sure for fit checks for their experiments, as well as like one of our biggest ones is WCI, making sure that we properly support them with our data with the incoming parts that are being made. And we do support Site 300. We have an inspector that supports them up there as needed when they have parts to be inspected with HE. We also do work, we do work with other laboratories as well. Right now we're working with Kansas City and we're working with the Nevada test site.
On top of the one-of-a-kind facility, on top of the remarkable challenges, on top of the singular mission, we have the opportunity to create something great here, and we have the tools to solve any problem. But if you look a little closer, you'll also see that the manufacturing facility is a unique family. So think about joining this family and apply for a position at the manufacturing facility today.
One of the benefits of working here at Lawrence Livermore National Lab is One is the people. You have a lot of smart people. As I mentioned, we work in teams. We are always learning from each other. We're always challenging the next generation, the next thing, whatever that may be. How do we become better? But it is very much a family atmosphere. We come to work, we do our job, we have a critical mission to the national security for stockpile stewardship and NSA. It's a key part of what we do. The apprentices go to all the different areas, they get to learn all the different techniques. That doesn't happen everywhere. Most places have certain technologies, you get sat in front of this. This is, you get flexibility of moving between areas and jobs. And we're not a production facility. We do our thing, we figure it out, and then we move on to the next thing. And when we get to see the results of what happened at the end and how it impacts the nation and national security, that's a big deal for a lot of people that work here.